Historians are not completely sure when Brushnell and his brother Urza began working on the construction of Submarine, later known as the Turtle. It was completed in the autumn of 1776, and its task was to carry and place an underwater mine under an enemy vessel. However, they had to solve many problems: how to ensure a sufficiency of oxygen, how to change direction and depth, how to transfer and attach a mine under the enemy vessel. The hull of the submarine, in the shape of a barrel, was made of oak plates, pulled together with metallic iron hoops. It was the period of wood, and to construct something like that was not a problem. However, mechanical parts required highly qualified and experienced craftsmen. To immerse the vessel, the operator flooded the lower chamber with water, and pumped out water to raise. He reached the required depth with the accurate ratio. This principle is still used even nowadays. There was a weight attached to the bottom to keep the submarine in a vertical position. The front propeller, controlled by pedals, was used for forward and backward movement. These two propellers were invented by Bushnell, and were described as oars or vanes of a windmill. The submarine changed direction using a rudder with a lever mechanism. Operating this machine was extremely physically and mentally demanding. Not to mention how brave the operator must have been. The air came into the submarine with two snorkels, which closed when the boat immersed. Because the submarine was small, oxygen was quickly lost. That was a reason why the operator had to swim on the surface, and immerse only in the case of risk of detection, and when attaching the mine to the hull of the enemy vessel. So the action had to be undertaken during the night. The only light was coming through a small window in the submarine's hatch. The mine that was invented by Bushnell had probably the shape of a barrel, and was loaded with 60 kilograms of gunpowder. It was enough to create a proper hole in the hull of a British warship. Ignition of gunpowder underwater was a challenge, as well as the timing of the explosion, so that Turtle and its operator could get into a safe distance. The team adjusted the watch machine so that after a set time, it could detonate the primary load in a musket match, which ignited the main load of gunpowder. The plan was to get under the British flagship, attach a mine to the hull and flee. Since no one had been able to do it before, and perhaps no one had really thought about it, the team expected panic and a complete weakening of the morale of the British Army. It sounds easy, isn't it? On a late summer night of 1776, Sergeant Lee slowly swam to HMS Eagle. Lee was exhausted, and he was trying to break through something what appeared to be an impenetrable metal barrier. That time he did not know that it was a metal coat around the ship's rudder hinge system. Exhausted, Lee had to give up due to lack of oxygen. His attempt was uncovered by a British guard, so he quickly detached the mine, so that he was lighter, and he tried his best to get to safety. However, that triggered the watch machine and the mine exploded. Although the action failed, George Washington called it a brilliant effort, what we have to agree with, because submarines became the most effective weapons of naval battles in the 20th century. It is worth mentioning that it took almost a century for technology to advance enough for the submarine to sink the ship. This happened in 1846 during the American Civil War, when submarine of Confederation H.L. Hunley sank an enemy battleship. But that is the topic for one of the next videos.